Cowboys Nation and YouTubers. It's that VA Dallas Cowboy fan coming back at you. Thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing, and commenting down below. I make these videos for me and you. And they're a little therapeutic. Because I know how everybody kind of freaked out with the news of Tyron Smith yesterday. Relax. It's a precautionary move. He probably just felt something and he wanted to go get it checked out. The fact that he was out there doing practice work before it happened kind of tells you it's something that just happened and he wants to get it checked out. It is his neck, and you know, he just had that surgically repaired, so you'd want to monitor that. Now, I for one think he needs to start having his Romo Wednesdays or something. He does not need to keep working out or practicing every single practice. What's he got to prove? Let some of them backups get some reps. That's in my opinion. I mean, you got nothing left to prove. You are one of the best left tackles in all of football. So why risk injury in practice? Which seems to happen more times than not. But hopefully it's just a precautionary move. They've already said that this will probably not hurt him from playing against the Patriots. I hope that's true. Same thing with Trayvon Diggs and his ankle. We kind of knew he tweaked his ankle against the Giants. And he kind of just, you know, got on the bike and worked it out. I mean, he came back in the game, had it taped up, and kept playing. So it's going to be a lingering issue, but I think more than likely he's just going to have get it rehabbed through the weeks until it gets fully better. But injuries come with the sport, you know. These guys are professionals. They're working through it. They're trying to do what's best for the team and what's best for themselves. It's a hard thing to do. Because you want to keep winning. You want to be that team at the end of the season. And speaking of that, Amari Cooper's already put that in the ether. That's what you're looking forward to at the end of this season. Now, I haven't... I haven't gone that far. It's hilarious when Scooter Magruder says it, but you know, reality says win your division, win your, the games you're supposed to win, and then when you get in the playoffs, anything can happen. So let's just do it game by game and see where we go from there. Let's see. What else? All right. Next up, I wanted to talk about the center issue. Unlike a previous regime where they just let shit sit and fester until it became a huge problem and then you're stuck at the end trying to figure shit out, these Cowboys are proactive and they've had all the guys who have center experience taking snaps. You had Dak with Tyler Biadasz. You had Connor McGovern with Cooper Rush. Connor Williams with Will Greer. And Matt Farniak with Ben DiNucci, I think. I think that's how it goes, how they went. But it's good that it's a problem. They recognized it, and they're trying to get in as much practice snaps as possible just for a need base, just in case. They're being proactive. That's something we don't normally do. And as I've said previously, quite a few times, this culture has changed a lot. And it's good seeing these guys getting ahead of a problem instead of waiting around until it festers and blows up in your face before they have to make a move. So this is good. This is good. I like it. It's great. You wouldn't have gotten this in the past. All right, and lastly, I wanted to talk about the NFC East. I talked yesterday about how New England stations and articles are calling us overrated and, you know, trying to throw shit on the wall and see if it sticks. That's what they do. That's going to be their clickbait. That's going to be whatever tries to motivate them, and that's fine and dandy. They're not the ones playing the game on Sunday. They're not the ones who got to put up or shut up. So they can say whatever they want to say, just like any talking head. But aside from our game, which I can't wait for, we can finally break a couple of streaks, hopefully. Namely, losing to Bill Belichick all these years and losing in New England all these years. Hopefully, both of those issues will be remedied this Sunday. But Eagles played Tampa Bay last night. It wasn't even close. They took their foot off the gas in the end. Tampa Bay still won 28-22, I do believe. And I just don't see it. The Eagles are just not ready. You see hints and glimmers of it, but a consistent basis thing is just not happening for them. They tried their damnedest, though, but they just have their issues, and you can kind of pin it on Nick Sirianni, whoever their head coach is, and Howie Roseman. Howie's the only consistent thing in that organization that's been fucking it up every year. So sooner or later, their ownership needs to figure out that he's not the man to be a GM. And in case you haven't seen the news today, tight end Zach Ertz has been traded away to Arizona Cardinals. They're hoping that makes them better because they lost their starting tight end for the season, so his production and experience, they're hoping will offset that, but he hasn't really done much in Philly, so we're not really sure what he's going to bring to their offense, but he's got his wish. He finally got traded away from Philly. They couldn't come to an agreement on a contract extension. He was upset. He wanted out, and they've already moved on to Dallas Goedert anyway in that offense. The only reason he wasn't there was because he was out for the game. COVID-related issues, I do believe. But he's finally free. We'll see if the Cardinals pay the man later on or not. He was traded away for a corner, Tay Bowen or something like that, and a 2022 fifth-round pick, I do believe. So, hope them greener pastures are good for him. And, you know, trying to say you were going to be Philly for life, it's like they're having a dumpster fire or fire sale, and they're just getting rid of pieces now. I think they already know their season's pretty much going downhill. Next up, you have the New York Giants against the LA Rams. If the Rams are on fire like they were before they lost to Arizona, that game's not going to be pretty. Daniel Jones is probably the only one who's going to make it back in time for that game. And you can't even trust him to be either 100% or even be that good without his weapons. So I'm not looking to see that they're going to win. But anything can happen on a Sunday. So it could be a fluke win. Who knows? Washington, all the controversy going on at that place. And they got to play Kansas City? In Kansas City, I don't believe. No. I think they got them at home. But either way, that's still a team that's, when they're firing on all cylinders, hard to stop them. And they're coming off of a loss. So the Giants and the Washington football team are coming in against teams that have lost and are pissed. I mean, we got the Patriots who lose and be pissed, but they're not ready to be primetime players. So I give us a shot against the rest of the NFC East to win and continue our dominance of the East with a three-game lead. But we'll have to see any given Sunday, right? But that's all I wanted to talk about. Get that stuff out. Happy Friday. Have a good weekend, everybody. I got tickets to go see James Bond with the fam. So excited to see that in IMAX. But you take care. Stay safe out there. And if anything else happens, you know we'll talk about it. This is VA Dallas Cowboy Fan, out.